Okay, let's go.
What Google has to say. Hopefully I can figure something out.
Masturbation is a form of witchcraft.
Okay, I guess we're gonna try it. Right. Here goes nothing. Okay guys, so I'm going to do the next video on the witch's black lint. And I'm going to do it on the other sin I'm working on, and that is lust. Now, in some ways, we are very quick to sexualize everything, such as the term a lust for life, a lust for power, a lust for money. And in some ways, lust in those connotations, except for the lust of life, is that you get as much sexual gratification is having things like money or power than you do committing a sexual act. having that desire, that passion in life can really be a positive thing. To get your goals accomplished, to do what you need done, to have a passion for something. Can really be a positive. And of course, even though, lust is a biological primal instinct, yet in our society, we tend to over-sexualize everything. As even in the Bible, it talks often in the Songs of Solomon, in that connotation. But unfortunately, even though there's a lot of talk about chastity and being pure until your marriage, culturally, it is still in some cultures to this day, the responsibility of the woman to maintain her chastity, and men get pats on the back. And even some pastors preach, like Greg Locke, that providing services to men and glorifying their lust is acceptable.
Of his shenanigans and his wicked nonsense. A woman will do things like this. Oh, you won't let me get my way? That's cool. Sleep on the couch, big daddy. And a woman will use and abuse the glory of the sexual marriage bed to get what she wants out of her husband. A woman can use her body for the purpose of manipulation. You say, well, I just don't think that's true. There would not be a prostitution industry without it.
Now, I do have issues with Christian society as they talk about lust and sexualizing everything and this movie and that movie and this song and that song. Nas, I believe, they had this big thing. Granted, I don't think that anyone putting their crotch in anyone's face, I fail to see why you need to do that in a video. But they'll go on about Nas and about Sam Smith and the Unholy Song, but yet they have no issues dressing children up, putting spray tans and makeup on them, and dressing them up like adults, and they call it beauty pageants. Why do we even need to have beauty pageants? What is that feeding? And what is that kind of message? But yet, we're so concerned about all of this rhetoric that they talk about with the anti-LGBTQ movement, because they are, seem to be so concerned and thinking that, like, trans and non, you know, that they're all giving into their lust, when in fact, in some, you know, with trans and non-binary, it's their identity. You know, again, we target kids with these drag shows, but it's perfectly acceptable to dress a child up like Dolly Parton or Pretty Woman before her transformation and parade these kids in this makeup and stuff out at these beauty pageants. So to me, it is a bit of hypocrisy there. And you know, sex can, there's all types of benefits to sex. But even at one point, Christian, in early days, Christian, within Christian Catholicism, you know, you were told what days of the week, what positions, you know, there again, the church has been about control when you're in the act of lust, that you have no control, whether it's with yourself or a partner. So, you know, but it can also, lust can also be very good for spell work within sex magic. So that's kind of all I have to say about that. Peace, love, and light, guys. But I think that, that Christians, with all of the all of the misconceptions, you know, to us as witches, sex and the act of sex is just as sacred to us, whether it's for sex magic or whatever. You know, it is just as sacred to us as part of a life cycle, you know, that it would be to a Christian. It's just, we don't necessarily have to have a ring on our finger. And actually, the act of the wedding ring was actually a pagan concept. Thank you.